Welcome back, brothers. I'm Mr. Muppet, and in this video I will teach everyone how to install the BaseBuildingPlus mod.
BaseBuildingPlus, baby!
We will follow all the steps to install this mod, and it will teach us how to install 95% of all other DayZ mods. Most mods have similar or less steps to complete. Let's dive right in. We must have a hosting service, like 4players.net or whatever. They're all a little different, and the cheap ones all suck. In the past I have used Nitrado, but their service is horrible and they have a lot of downtime. 4players gives you less control in their browser and makes you work with FileZilla or any other client to upload your files, but their uptime is really good, so for this tutorial we will focus on 4players. Next, we download FileZilla. We need FTP software to transfer files, and FileZilla is free and stable. Subscribe to the mods in Steam. Now, how do we do that? First, open Steam, then go to Community, and then Workshop. Search for DayZ and then BaseBuildingPlus without any spaces. Subscribe to the mod and a check mark will appear. We can see that this mod has dependencies. CF is required. If we click on it, we can subscribe to CF as well. And while you're at it, subscribe to my channel. I also have a link directly to the workshop of BBP in the description. We still have to download the mods. Open DayZ, and if it asks for DayZ or the DayZ client, click DayZ. We can see a browser screen and we will look at the mods. In mods, we can load up BBP and CF. To download the mods, click on the mod you need, click the three dots, then click Open Folder in Windows Explorer. Click I understand after the warning. This location shows all the mods you have stored locally. For easy access, select both BBP and CF. Copy them and paste them on your desktop. Before uploading or editing any files on the server, make sure it stopped running. To connect to the hosting server, we start up FileZilla and connect. In the FTP section, we can retrieve all the information needed. In FileZilla, we can fill in the host, username, password, and port, and click Connect. On the left we see the local files on our computer, on the right the files stored on the server. We locate the files needed and drag and drop them to the root folder. The root folder for 4players is a 6-digit number. Depending on the size of the mods, this may take a while to upload. I already changed my password, so forget about it. In every mod folder, there's a subfolder called keys. In this folder is a .bykey file. We want to transfer this file to the root folder. The designation for this file is a folder also called keys, located in the root folder. We should transfer all the keys for the mods in use. Sometimes different mods have the same keys we can skip or overwrite if a pop-up asks what we want to do. We have to enter the mods into the server. For 4net players, there is a specific syntax that all mods have to end with a semicolon. We have to enter the exact folder name as mod name as well. So for example, the BBP folder is named @BBP. That means we can add @BBP and end with a semicolon. In rare cases, the order matters. My advice is to always put the dependencies first. In this case, the order would be CF, then BBP. With 4 net players, there are 2 locations you have to adjust this. There are basic settings located under basic config and server settings. In the advanced settings, the location is configuration and command line. We always want to change both. Entering the mod in basic settings will change the advanced settings as well. However, entering the mod in advanced settings will not change basic settings. Always enter this info in mods instead of server mods. The first time a mod is loaded, it will automatically create a folder. The location is the profile folder, although this differs per hosting server. To start this process of creating folders, all we have to do is start up the server. After fully starting it, we stop the server again. Now we can check if the folder is visible. Remember that not all mods create extra folders. Examples of mods that create extra folders are BBP, CodeLock and Zoneberry. We can check if the folder is visible by logging into FileZilla, or we can check it in our FTP section in the browser. Go to FTP and click on the Web FTP login button under Save Games. Select the profile folder. Here we can see all the folders that are created by the server. If the BBP folder is not there, we have to stop and start the server again until it is created. For most mods, these are all the steps we have to take. We can start the server and enjoy our mods. For BBP, there's one extra step we have to complete. We have to merge some files. Stop the server to do this final step. If we skip this step or make mistakes, our structures will disappear over time. The files that we have to merge are the types.xml files. One file is the vanilla types.xml file. In this file, all the vanilla objects are stored on the server. There are all sorts of parameters in this file. Let's look at the document to understand it a bit. At the top, we can see the standards of the document, version, encoding, and game type. Below that, we can see types. This is basically a way of opening a list of objects. Every list has to be closed as well. If we scroll all the way to the bottom, we see slash types. The slash indicates the closing of this list. In this list of objects, we have many objects called type that are opened and closed as well. If we open this document in Explorer, for example, we can easily read it. The blue colors indicate the names for all files, objects and variables. The light blue colors indicate variables. The white colors indicate integers. Integers are numbers. And the orange colors indicate variable names. We can also click on the triangles, which folds an entire object. As you can see, the opening of the type object looks a bit different. The name is included in the opening. For example, type name is ACOG Optic. This is exactly the same as writing type and then name is ACOG Optic. Now we understand what this document is, we can merge them. In other words, we add more objects to this file. The BBP file is located in the folder on your desktop copied earlier. Open the folder named info, there you should see BBP types XML. Copy paste it to your desktop. With 4 net players, the vanilla file is not located in your server. You have to create one yourself. You can either locate it in the Dayz folder or download it from GitHub. The link is below in the description. The location in the Dayz server is at the location where you installed Steam. Under the folder, Steam Apps, Common, Dayz Server, MP Missions, Dayz Offline.Chernarus+, if you're using Chernarus. For another map, you need a corresponding folder. And then the DB folder. Here you can see types.xml. Copy paste this file to your desktop as well. The BBP types.xml is full of objects that need to be added to the server. The location doesn't really matter, but I prefer to add them to the bottom. The easiest thing to do is download both of them. Open both in Notepad, select all the content from the BBP types.xml with Ctrl A. Copy this content with Ctrl C. Now we go to the location where we want to paste it. Make a little room with Enter and we paste the content with Ctrl V. Make sure to check everything is copied and nothing is overwritten by accident. check for validity in Explorer or your favorite online XML checker. Everything is good to go now. We can check with the Dayz SA launcher if all mods are loaded. If they are not, you will get some errors back. To fix it, we can try a restart of the server. Sometimes it helps, and sometimes we need to do some more digging. If you need more help, you can check out a GitHub. For any more help, you're always welcome to join the BBP Discord. Both links are below in the description. Enjoy! If you found this video helpful, please subscribe to my channel. See you when I see you.